never going to run smooth, is it?
It's a soap wedding. Of course it's not going to run smoothly.
It's a soap wedding, but it's a relationship that's had its ups and downs and had its traumas and its hurdles along the way.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a great kind of love story, but throughout David's cancer, we didn't want to dwell on the cancer too much, so the love story between David and Tracy came through that and kind of blossoms at the end. So it's been a good, hard 6 months, but it's been great.
A great storyline to get your teeth into, though, isn't it?
I love you, but...
It's been amazing, absolutely amazing. The feedback from people via Twitter who have had any types of cancer that have got in touch with me and just said how, not particularly how well I've done the storyline, but how well Emmerdale's done it and how they've done it, how they've written it, how the storylined it has just been spot on. So it's been a pleasure to do.
We saw a little clip of you there, and it's still striking that your hair's here and your eyebrows have come back because you've been doing it all, haven't you? You've been shaving your head.
So it's been about 5-6 months, yeah, every morning. Everything, chest, arms, anything that was going to be seen on the camera, I had to shave.
Not quite.
But I had to have an extra hour in makeup every morning and... to get everything shaved off. So.
Were you worried that because there's certain parts sometimes don't come back, so your eyebrows...
I'd heard horror stories from people who'd had their eyebrows shaved off like in drunken stupors at university and they'd never grown back. So, yeah, after 5 months of shaving them, I was a bit worried they wouldn't, but they seem to be... they're coming through. If not, I'll just get them tattooed on it. It'll be fine.
And what did Charlie, of course, you're engaged to, plays Debbie Dingle, what did she make of your new look? Because it's quite dramatic when you know someone with hair and obviously eyebrows and everything. It's like, ooh, what have you done?
I think she quite liked the bald head. It was when the eyebrows and the stubble came off and everything came off. And it's really striking once your eyebrows come off. You don't look like you anymore.
No.
It's a real, real change to your face. So she wasn't too keen on that. Buster loved it. My oldest son, he just adored it. He thought every time I shaved it, he wanted to feel my head because it felt so smooth. And yeah, so he thought it was great.
But you're stuck with the look though, aren't you? Because while you had this full sort of setup for Emmerdale, you had to get your passport done.
I had to have a new passport done, yeah.
And we've actually got a picture. This is your passport photo. It's a bit blurred, but we've taken... That's you on your passport photo.
I know, for 10 years, and that's genuinely my passport. I've got it with me today, so you could take that picture. So for 10 years now, I've got that picture on my passport. I might have to lose it at some point and get a new one. But
were you getting mistaken for anyone?
Well, Roxana, who plays Layla, when I first had it all shaved off, she said, oh, you remind me of someone. You remind me of someone off a film. And I thought she was going to say, like, Bruce Willis or somebody bored, somebody cool. And she went, who is it? Gollum. You look like Gollum. Like, oh, brilliant. Thanks for that.
Nothing like your mates.
Not such a good thing.
No.
It's going to happen, is it? The wedding will happen.
I'm not telling you. You're going to have to watch tomorrow.
I think it's going to start to happen. We don't know if it ends.
Did they ever get there?
Well, that's the other chance.
Lovely to see you. I'm glad everything's grown back carefully as well.
Good to see you.
What is it for an actor about being the villain that gives you... You said empowers you.
I think it's because she doesn't have a filter, and that's really fun to play. Mm. I think especially if you go through life with a big one like mine, and you're very careful about what you say to people, to be able to say what you like and not care about repercussions or what people think of you is really